Well, what are the current developments at ICC Georgia?
We are growing in number. We are close to 200 companies now. Maybe the biggest development that we had is that in July we declared a moratorium on criticizing the government till October to give a chance to the Investors Council under the Prime Minister to solve the problems that we have been talking about since about 3 years now, to solve them far from the limelights, not to discredit anyone and not to give credit to anyone else. So we will see how this investor council is going to work. If it's going to work well, then there will be no need for us to go public. If it's not going to work, then definitely we'll have to go back to the media and speak openly about the problem. There are four main complaints. The first one relates to new legislation. You know, every few days we have a new piece of legislation that is adopted without consultation with the business community. And this is a real problem because we cannot keep up and then we don't know what's happening. And this is backfiring very negatively on the confidence of businesses and investors in the country. The second issue is the revenue service. The revenue service is very aggressive with the companies. Whenever they audit a company, they decide of arbitrary penalties that can be folds what the company needs to be penalized if it needs to be penalized. They freeze the bank accounts, totally paralyze the company. They help themselves self-service in the account of the company and transfer to the budget. The appeal process is very long and very lengthy, and this is a real problem. So this is a second issue. The third issue relates to the labor inspection. We are quite apprehensive about it. It's a new watch body that will be watching over businesses and controlling body, in addition to the competition agency and to the revenue service. And this is not good news because it's complicating the business climate. And finally, the fourth issue relates to the courts. The courts are issuing injunctions against defendants, requesting the freezing of assets that are many folds the value of the claim against those companies and thus totally paralyzing the companies. Those are the four main issues that are of big concern to the business community, and we hope that through the Investment Council we will be able to solve them.
What are the main obstacles that foreign investors face in Georgia?
You know, investors want predictability. They want visibility. Without visibility and predictability, investors are not interested in countries, especially in a small country like Georgia. For the past 3 years, the government has issued a lot of business-unfriendly legislation that have cooled down investors, scared them off, and they are looking for other destinations than Georgia. Fortunately, the government has partially reversed this bad legislation, but it's too late. I believe that the main problem now is to restore confidence. The confidence in the future of Georgia for businesses and investors have been lost in the past 3 years. And now what we need to do, together with the government, is make sure that confidence is restored so people invest in their own country and foreign investors do invest as well in Georgia.
It is often said that doing business in Georgia is very easy.
On paper it's easy. But practically, it's not that easy, especially when you have to deal with the revenue service, with the competition agency, with the Georgian courts, with the labor inspection. No, it is not as easy as you can read on paper, okay? And this is a real problem because, you know, it takes one failure to spoil 100 success stories. And since we don't have 100 success stories, we shouldn't be surprised why Georgia has lost its reputation as a good place for business and investment.
Does Georgian government do enough for attracting foreign investors?
I cannot criticize the government regarding their will to attract foreign investors. The will is there. What is not there is the understanding of what foreign investors need. This means that if you are in Saudi Arabia and you open a restaurant, and the menu is beer and pork, don't be surprised if you have no clients. And in Georgia is exactly the same. The government is not serving investors what the investors want to eat. And the government is unable to understand what investors, what are the problems that investors suffer from. I think that Georgians are ambivalent regarding foreigners. They have like a double approach to foreigners. There is the social approach to foreigners, where Georgians are extremely generous, extremely hospitable, extremely nice. And there is the professional approach to foreigners, where there is professional xenophobia. This means that Georgians don't like to see foreign people operating in the country, working in the country. They're very happy to see them as tourists drinking wine around a supra, enjoying the landscape, yes, but they don't like to see foreigners working in Georgia in general, not all of them, of course, but in general, there is a professional xenophobic feeling in the country.
In which sectors new investors can expect rapid positive returns?
I think that tourism has a huge potential, definitely. There is a lack of infrastructure for tourism, and investors can get involved in it. I see Georgia really booming tourism-wise. I don't know anyone who came to Georgia who didn't want to come another time, and the third time, and the fourth time. So tourism is definitely. Then you have medium-sized industries. Let's say paint factory, paper tissue factories, you know, not big factories in hundreds of millions of dollars, anything between, let's say, $5 and $20 million industries. This is what we are lacking here. And we are really in a very comfortable position, considering that Georgia has signed a DCFTA and an association agreement with the EU. This means you have 500 million consumers now that are at the grab of the hand. We have cheap labor. The lari is weak. So we have all the parameters in hand to be very successful for medium-sized industries.
You often meet Georgian government. What percent of these meetings have positive results?
It depends on the government officials. For example, when Minister Virikashvili was Minister of Economy, I can say that 70% of our requests were coming with positive results. He was fantastic as a Minister of Economy, and as a person, he was fantastic. I mean, we really from the whole government, I can say that we had the best relation with him. He always listened very carefully. He understood what was the problem, and he took action. Unfortunately, we lost him as a Minister of Economy, but we gained him as a Minister of Foreign Affairs. Now, the Minister of Finance, whenever we come with a problem, he makes his utmost to solve the problem. But this is a tactical approach. But at the strategic level, considering that he oversees the revenue service, he never wanted to understand what were the real problems with the revenue service and the cost of the actions of the revenue service on the economy. You know, I mean, I always think of the Minister of Finance as someone who's colorblind. This means that you tell him this is red, and he tells you, no, it's yellow, okay? He cannot see the problem because he's not experienced in it, I mean, from the perspective of businesses. But every time we went and talked to him for a particular issue, he was always extremely helpful, and he made sure to solve it. But you cannot always tactically solve the matters. The economic advisor to the Prime Minister, Ombudsman Georgi Gakharia, also is always open. So, in general, I can say that for tactical problems, for punctual problems, the government solved them. But strategically, there is a lack of vision and a lack of understanding, and this is the main issue, and this is what we're trying to explain to them, that they need to change strategy.
If we take 10-point system, what would you give Georgian government?
10 points, 3. A generous 3. I'm speaking of the economy. A generous 3 on the economy. I'm not speaking of social issues and other issues. Just speaking of the economy.
As the Georgian citizen, do you believe in NATO or EU future?
Here I'm going to answer you for myself, not for the International Chamber of Commerce. Personally, I don't think that Georgia will be a member of NATO anytime soon. And I don't think that Georgia will integrate in the EU anytime soon, not at least as long as I'm alive, okay? let us be pragmatic about it. Regarding the EU is having its own problem internally. They're having a problem with their own Greece and Spain and Italy, and they're not in the process now of enlarging itself, okay? Concerning NATO, we know the situation with the Russians and all this. I don't think that NATO is gonna impose membership to Russia. I mean, this is my personal opinion. So I think that we need to be a little pragmatic, not to focus too much on it. I think that Georgia today is still Western oriented. But if you compare the poor results 2 years ago to the poor results 3 months ago, you will see that the enthusiasm toward the West is fading. And this is not because of the Georgians. This is because of the attitude of the West toward Georgia. You know, the NATO map has been postponed year after year after year. The visa facilitation also has been postponed. And, you know, I mean, Georgians feel very frustrated. And, you know, you have, you know, Georgians are very proud. They're not beggars. And the message that they are receiving from the West is that as if they are begging for something. So for a proud nation, I understand this feeling within the population that, okay, I mean, if Europe doesn't want of us, or they don't want to give us visa facilitation, or if we cannot be on the map soon for the map, then let's forget about it. I mean, we survived for millennia without the EU. We can survive another millennia without the EU, especially that the EU, they're having their own problems internally. Having said that, I believe that the EU really needs to make an effort towards Georgia. You know, signing a DCFTA and an association agreement leads to a very high compliance cost for the economy. You know, we have to adapt our legislation with the EU legislation, and this is going to have a cost on the economy because this will complicate the doing business in the country. Now, by the same token, we need to see something in return. And this is the feeling that the Georgians are getting now, the frustration that they're getting. They see that they are paying, they're paying, and they're getting nothing in return. And the EU needs to make a very serious effort regarding this issue, because I believe that if Georgians at some stage change direction, and it is possible, and head towards Russia, it will not be the Georgians' fault, it will be the EU fault and the West fault.